thank you for inviting me and giving us, the representative of the donor side, the chance to contribute to the conference. I wouldn't say that is us representing the demand side, because the demand is on either side, on both sides. And there's also a question of the interface where both sides meet and exchange, and how we organize and manage the infrastructures in SSA's research. And also this conference is part of this exchange. My short presentation will be divided up into three parts: a small introduction going back to the history and aims, then in the main part illustrating some examples of where my ministry is active in supporting infrastructures, with a special focus on the connection to European initiatives. And in the end, I'll try to give a small outlook to future. The concept that is developed in Germany is follows some basic features of the landscape. The academic landscape of the humanities and social sciences is enormous, not only in the numbers of participants, but also in the diversity and of the topics and approaches, and also in the depth of the experiences and expertise in the digital methodologies. So new digital methodologies are opening up new opportunities for research in all SSH disciplines. That's the claim. And data collection and development of new digital methodologies require close interdisciplinary work between the various SSH disciplines and computer sciences, not to develop what we call Insellösung, a solution only for a small island, but connected to the scientific exchange. And hence a transformation of hermeneutical to quantitative approaches of SSH methodologies is not applicable. Digital methodologies, in our perspective, enhance existing approaches rather than replace them by different ones. In general, we follow overall three goals, which could be named as interoperability, sustainability, and an integrated approach. Interoperability, which is also part of the FAIR principles, is absolutely in line with what Alice Fiala yesterday from the Commission said, to have a connection not only between single universities or research groups, but in larger entities, nationwide, Europe-wide, worldwide. And therefore, the political vision of an EOSC, an European Open Science Cloud, was created. The sustainability is also quite important, because it distinguishes from initiatives that come and go to what is really needed and has to be established for a long, long term. ESFRI is a forum that helped developing the European needs, but it even goes beyond, because the sustainability also requires different funders in different phases of research infrastructure initiatives. And finally, the integrated approach wants to enhance that research infrastructures are not provided from a service field, but are maintained within science, from science, but also within science, including not only collecting data and interpreting, interpreting them, but also the training, the teaching, the further development of methodologies, and the hosting of data, and guaranteeing a long-term availability. When it comes to humanities in particular, the history is quite brief in Germany, because it's only 10 years ago that first funding initiative for the arts and humanities was launched from our ministry, which was called Freiraum für die Geisteswissenschaften, Freedom for the Humanities. And ever since, my ministry's funding grew very high from low rates in the beginning to quite some amounts in presence. And the initial lack of appropriate digital infrastructure has led to a first large series of two SSH research infrastructures. Mainly, these were the predecessors of Clarin and Daria, which we called in Germany DSpin in 2008 and TextGrid in 2006. And what was special with these is that more universities were involved than the classical research infrastructure providers we have in Germany, which are connected to large research associations. You might know Max Planck Society or Helmholtz Association or even the Leibniz Association. Here, the libraries and the universities themselves play a larger role, which is special to the humanities. And this also is a challenge for the sustainability, because the research associations receive annual funds to run the infrastructures for also the universities as customers, but this is not true for the infrastructures in the humanities. What they have in common is that they are distributed and by now internationally linked, but this will be our main part. In the social sciences, we had a little bit different history, because as early as in the 1960s, the need for social sciences, for central services, became obvious, and so we established small infrastructures even then. Services were meant to be panels, surveys, and archival services, and that's why in 1986, BMBF funded the GESIS, which is an abbreviation for the Gesellschaft Sozialwissenschaftlicher Infrastruktureinrichtungen, I think this is understood, as a cooperation of three separate infrastructures and in three separate organizations, and in 2007 they merged into one institutionalized infrastructure for social science data, which from then on received guaranteed annual funds. In 1984, the Socioeconomic Panel, SOEP, was founded as an institutionalized infrastructure at the Deutsches Institut für Wirtschaftsforschung, DIW, in Berlin. And all is also parallel with strong cooperation with the German Research Foundation, DFG. So to bring this all together, we have had these two predecessors, and then the classical Big Five, Daria, Clarin, ESS, Share, and CESTA. Germany is a member in all five of them. That's why we all also staff the ERICS directly or with our agency, and why we participate in the strategic working group SCI, Social and Cultural Innovation. And even further with the three new applicants to the S3 roadmap, ERI, Operas, and Resilience, they all three have German partners, so we are very close to this process as well. To be mentioned, these timelines do not mean that Germany will retreat. It's just the phase where we have project funds and they have to renew it again and again, but will not last forever. And we look for institutionalized funded infrastructures in the near future. For ESS and CESTA, this could have been achieved, but for Daria and Clarin, this is a process to be continued. I have to add that it's not only the ministry funding these infrastructures, it's in case of SHARE, it's also the Max Planck Society and the Deutsche Forschungsgemeinschaft, German Research Council, with big funds, even in longer terms. There is more, there are other infrastructures which should be mentioned briefly, which might not be known in the European approach. This is two new ones. It's a research association with the names of Marbach, Weimar, Wolfenbüttel, and by the names you might know these are the hotspots of German literature and literature research. This is the background. They've been granted a project phase which ends this year, and the next phase is applied and probably coming up for the next 5 years. Another one is quite younger. It's called Kultsam. It's about scientific collections in Germany. Also could be thought of as an infrastructure. They are in a design phase, and we'll see what comes up afterwards. It's also a very European topic when it comes to European culture and heritage. In the social sciences, we have also the social economic panel, SOEP, which provides longitudinal panel data sets of the population in Germany. It was initially funded by the DFG, and then my ministry took over. But it also offers us to include other funders, namely the Federal Labor Office or the Federal Office for Migration and Refugees, and we could start new initiatives with societal needs. There's a new survey on refugee families, which was not planned 10 years ago, but it could be really fast implemented. The Rat SWD, Rat für Sozial- und Wirtschaftsdaten, is a consulting committee to the federal government since 2004. With its core task is the accreditation of research data centers, and so far 31 research data centers, 8 academic members and 8 data centers could have been certified. We do also have a national roadmap process in Germany, which was launched once, but the entrance ticket is that the construction costs of research infrastructure, especially for SSH, is at least 20 million euros. And this does not include the operating costs, just the infrastructure building up, which is, in other cases, building houses and building synchrotrons, ships, satellites. And this all does not apply to what we need as an infrastructure in social sciences and humanities. So far, no one of our research infrastructures has met this threshold, this 20 million, and probably in future it will be difficult. Although this level is lowered in other, for the natural sciences or health sciences, it's 50 million. Parallel to the infrastructures, we have to have a look on the national project calls. Because we see it as a twin, not mandatory, but we want to, that the scientists make use of the national infrastructures provided. So before we issue calls for project funds, we hold hearings. The scientists, I think this is always common policy, to determine the needs that the scientific field has in this particular area. And then we open the call and are open to ideas that are not given, that is basically free. We rather look for the structures we want to fund. So in the e-humanities, we launched the first call 7 years ago for these interdisciplinary researchers, where we asked for consortia of humanities and information technology researchers, but the field of occupation was free. And this was followed in 2013 and 14 with each 2 funding lines. One was focusing on grants for junior research groups to attract and educate even more young scientists, and also the foundation of digital humanities centers, DH centers we call them. You could also call them centers of excellence or clusters of excellence, because they had a very regional approach where existing partners were linked up with additional money. And we had calls issued on e-heritage, on digitization, including 2 funding lines. One was more for concepts, what could be and how should it be digitized, and then a realization phase where which were longer, were, I have to say that it was not our main task to digitalize texts or printed texts. Rather, we focused on objects, could be musics, sound files, or also architectural plans. At least when the archives approached us, they have to prove that there is a scientific interest to digitalize it, not only for its own sake, but for a question. These calls, I want to illustrate a little bit with numbers. The first one with the e-humanities call, we had around 60 single projects running for 3 years. Then in the interdisciplinary junior research groups, we funded 6 groups for 4 plus 1 year. And finally, we had 9 DH centers founded. And in the e-heritage line, we had 29 concepts and for only 9 months funded, and 24 projects that came up to realization, and they will run for another 2 years now. Expressed in figures, this is these 4 lines, summing up to some 56.5 million euro in the last 6 years. And this has to be seen in parallel to what we spend for the infrastructures. This is not to be read, but it shows you that they are not of equal size. And added together, it's some 70 million euro in roughly 10 years. So added to the project funds, we have 126 million euros spent in the last 10 years. This just give you an impression about the German part in these ESFRI and endeavors. When it comes to future, it's a little bit difficult because we don't have an elected government right now. We have an acting government since last September, and a new government should also have follow new policies. But as it looks now, the new government will pretty much look like same like the old government, so we are quite confident that we can continue. Nevertheless, we have to ask ourselves and ask the science sector if more of the same is what's needed, or if we have to have some reorientation or more methodological development. For instance, we think about a special call about software development, not only for the IT, but for research needs of the SSH sector, if this proves demanded. Therefore, we will have talks to scientific groups, but we are quite positive that we will put another call on the e-heritage issue, because there's a very strong need, and it's quite an effort. We will not cover all what's hidden in German archives, but at least when we can prove a scientific interest through letters of interest and a university partner, we are quite willing to open up again a new call. And in overall terms, it's the 4 FAIR principles we follow, but we see a need to harmonize and enhance the SSH research infrastructures on a European level. That has been begun in the past, but will also influence our funding. And we also, parallel to the European Open Science Cloud, we have a German parallel, a process called Nationale Forschungsdateninfrastruktur, NFDI, which should be the rooftop above all infrastructures of any field in Germany. It's not quite determined how the pillars of this building will look like, but for the humanities, we want to rely on Daria and Clarion as a sustainable national research infrastructure hubs, and we think they could have a national lead function, and that's why we supported them holding a series of workshops in this year, in 2008, to communicate within the community the common needs and interests and to support the self-organization of our research infrastructures. In the social sciences, we will follow the development of accreditation guidelines and evaluation mechanisms for the RAD SWD. The harmonization and standardization is still something that needs to look after, but this is ongoing. And I hope with these rough overview, I could give you a glimpse, an idea where the ministry is active in. So thank you for your attention.